gear up as a pair of javelins climb away from their base. It is early 1964, for the crews of 60 Squadron, based on the tropical resort island of Penang, their tour in the Far East is about to take an unusual direction. RAAF Butterworth, along with Singapore, is one of only two main air bases on the Malaysian mainland. Busy on a refuel and rearm exercise, the ground crews realize these events may be significant. Tension in Malaysia is high. In the Brunei oil fields, a communist revolt is nipped in the bud by prompt Gurkha action. Indonesian army units probe the 1,000-mile Borneo border. Help is requested from Britain. This, a logistic nightmare. The two small airfields of Kuching and Labuan perform miracles for an army totally dependent on air supply. Hunters and javelins on detachment from their mainland bases provide the air defense element. Air supply is tasked for Hastings, Beverly, and Valletta aircraft. Occasionally, the drop zones are forward enough for the transports to require a fighter escort. Because of their speed differential, the Hastings needs to be setting course while the Javelin crew are still making their pre-flight checks. A rendezvous is planned before arrival at the drop zone. The proclamation of an air defense identification zone guarded by RAF fighters coincides with the sudden halt of Indonesian Air Force incursions into Malaysian airspace. Apart then from cockpit readiness and escort missions, random border patrols are part of the operational plan. A sortie to Long Jawi, for instance, takes a full fuel load. This allows but 5 minutes on the deck in the target area before returning high level on fuel economy settings. Tropical rainforest is not easy country to navigate. Initially, too, the location of the border is uncertain. The first crews have to draw their own maps. However, once photo recce has completed a mosaic, intelligence gathered from friendly Dayak tribes and from SAS patrols, then operations become more routine. For the troops on the ground, everything comes in by parachute. Mail, ammo, food, even Christmas turkeys still alive and kicking. By its constant usage, the airborne supply has become a very slick operation. 3 years after the start of hostilities, Indonesia requests the end of confrontation. The once hastily improvised plan of the Allied forces has developed into a winning and brilliant campaign in one of the most remote and inaccessible areas of the world.